Of course, bridges are cool. They are and always have been at the cutting edge of engineering throughout history. We use the word bridge in conversation. We make bridges. We burn them. We cross them. We build them. They're not only metaphors, they're also apparently iconic. Tower Bridge, Golden Gate Bridge, Brooklyn Bridge, Sydney Bridge, and wonders of the modern world. And a subject of films and stories. A Bridge Too Far, Bridge Over the Real Kwai, a London Garden Bridge. And they come in so many shapes and sizes. I'm going to show off some of the coolest bridges in Wales because it has lots of valleys and rain, lots of water to cross. So for a small country, it crams in a lot of extraordinary bridges. In this episode, I'm going to look at the top railway bridges, some record-breaking, some in just fabulous locations, and some film stars. Up first is the first ever rail bridge, or rather tram bridge. It's in Merthyr, but as you enter the town, you will pass this more recent A-frame footbridge. It harks back in design to the Ponty Cavney, translated as Trough Bridge, that goes over the River Taff. It was the first iron tram bridge, and also an aqueduct that dates from 1793, predating the first ever iron rail bridge proper by about 30 years. That was the Gurnless Bridge, built by Stevenson, and 12 years after the first ever iron road bridge at Ironbridge. The designer Watkin George came from a timber engineering background, hence the joints of the cast iron bridge feature dovetailing. This prefabricated design was made at the local Quivava Ironworks along with a footbridge, although this is the only survivor. Sadly, it's been closed due to safety concerns. I did contact Merthyr Council to find out their plans to restore this historically important bridge, but still await a reply. Staying in Merthyr, there are two impressive viaducts. Cefn Viaduct is the third largest in Wales, and now a Grade 2 listed structure. It was constructed in early 1866 on a curve, so the railway line avoided property owned by the ironmaster, Robert Thompson Crawshay. The last trains travelled over this viaduct in the mid-60s, and it subsequently fell into disrepair. It was refurbished with lottery funding and is now part of the Taff Trail and Route 8 of the National Cycleway. Also constructed in the 1860s, the Pont Sarn Viaduct was built to carry the Brecon of Merthyr Tydfil Railway over the Taff Vecan River. The name Pont Sarn loosely means Bridge of the Long Road, the road in question being a branch of the Roman Road from Gloucester to West Wales. For a variety, we head north to the village of Tullibont and Usk, where we hit Peak Bridge. It's on the Brecon Merthyr line, and you can see the whole route in another video, link in the description. Here we have a road bridge over a river, an aqueduct over the river, a rail bridge over the road, a rail bridge over the canal, a tram bridge over the canal, and at some point, the railway carried over the tramway. And there are two pubs in the village. I include the remains of the Walnut Tree Viaduct that stands on the A470 at Taff Vale as a tribute to some impressive engineering, but also a visual example of what a million bricks look like. Built in 1901 to create an alternative route for coal from the valleys to Barry Docks, it took the high elevation route to avoid the congestion of the old rail line that went to Cardiff Docks. It was a steel lattice girder design on brick columns, and it was dismantled in 1969. This steel lattice girder bridge and lad dilo over the River Towy demonstrates the design. The bridge was built in 1856 and is a listed structure. For high-level viaducts, Crumlin on the Taff Vale extension line was a world beater built in 1857. It's described as one of the most significant examples of technology achievement during the Industrial Revolution. In its 109 years of service until being dismantled in 1967, it remained the least expensive bridge for its size ever constructed, the highest rail viaduct in the UK, and the third highest viaduct in the world. It was also a film star with a role alongside Sophia Loren and Gregory Peck in the 1966 American comedy thriller spy film Arabesque. When I visited the village and asked around, people remember the day Hollywood came to town, and I'll do a more detailed video on the bridge in future. The Hangoed Viaduct was also part of the Taff Vale extension line, again opened in 1854. And whilst it's no record breaker, it's quite stunning and part of a pedestrian route. Another possible record holder for being the highest in altitude viaduct in Britain is Cumpriso Bridge on the Bala Festiniog line. The full route is explored in my Parallel Lines video. There's a link in the description. Built in 1882, it is at an elevation of 400 metres, although only 32 metres high, and forms part of a permitted footpath that hugs the valley. It too also appeared on TV in the climax of the 2017 Welsh Gandhi Noir series, Hidden. This viaduct at Chirk, built in 1848, shares this crossing with the older aqueduct designed by Thomas Telford and completed in 1805. A little further up in the next valley is Pont Caselte Aqueduct over the River Dee, and again also designed by Telford. Close by, the railway line crosses the river a little further downstream at Kefan. The Barmouth Bridge is over 800 metres long, is Britain's longest timber viaduct, and about the third longest in the UK. It's still in use, built in 1867, it forms part of the Cambrian Line, and there's also a foot and cycle bridge. Grandeur, and another first, the Conway Railway Bridge has it all. Constructed in 1848, it was the first tubular bridge by Robert Stephenson, son of George. And the architect Francis Thompson designed the neo-medieval pylons as barbicans to match Edward Duell and his Ring of Iron. The adjoining bridge was joint first row suspension bridge with the nearby Menai Strait Bridge, built by Thomas Telford in 1826 and now pedestrian only. So, thanks for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe, which all help me in tackling the perversities of the YouTube algorithm. And if you want to see more of this kind of content, consider being a patron through Patreon.